So they worked with him on an album, which is like, you know, kind of groundbreaking in the use of synths for pop music. It's not like nobody ever used synths before, but the sophistication and
yeah. Well, I was, you know, sad but impressed when you moved to Ghana. I took the worst out for
you. You moved to Ghana, Steve?
Yeah. When I was writing the song Enough is Enough, so that was COVID and Donald Trump, 2020, 2021, and he had been visiting Ghana. Basically, he said, you know, even for a superstar like me, you know, it's just sick of being a second class status because of my skin color, whereas in Ghana, everyone's black. And he, I don't know what else he liked about Ghana. Singer and drums.
Yeah, but also he played down like ambient kind of keyboard kind of tracks and different guest people participating in different tracks. But apparently, I read the review in the Washington Post, apparently, he said he told me his grandmother, he helped his grandmother dig the graves of three of the four girls killed in the church. He sounds like he's got like a lovely heart still. It's interesting. It's not like it's interesting. It's like somebody's been
so who sends you these? Record company or just
well, the record company sends it to the radio to the music director.
But
and the music director forwarded.
Okay, so it's not like the music director is seeking these out.
No, they get whatever is new that the record companies want to send.
Interesting.
You know, I'm now on the list of, I don't know how many jazz reviewers there are, but you know, they have too many. And the Lonnie Holly, I don't know how to classify the radio station has it organized by genres, and I picked the lead genre experimental.
Daniel Music Building Recital Hall. We have, my name is Matt Olson. I coordinate the Jazz Studies program here at Furman. And you might be wondering, as you look around the room, why aren't there more people here? Why aren't there any students here? Okay, hey, there are a few. Where are they all? Well, as it turns out, the Furman Paladin Regiment Marching Band is in Ireland. They're all week this week, and they're there to march in the St. Patrick's Day Parade in Dublin. And so I get a second week of spring break. It's pretty awesome. So I literally have no teaching responsibilities this week, so but I get to hang with these guys, so that's cool too. And then we have a few students who are going with the North Greenville University basketball band to play at the NCAA basketball tournament because Furman made the tournament boo-hoo. And so it's kind of a ghost town around here. And you're wondering, well, why in the world did you schedule a guest artist if the students weren't going to be here? And why would you have a saxophonist come to campus of all your saxophone students who are in Ireland? That's an honest mistake of mine. Jordan had a few things that he was doing consecutively, and I didn't have the dates of the Ireland trip on my thing, and by the time we kind of signed up for everything, I was like, you know what? There are some people right here who are going to come out and enjoy here in Florida. So, it'll be a small, intimate gathering here tonight. And thank you very much for being here. I was wondering if, you know, we might just be playing for the live stream and nobody else, and it felt very COVID era-esque when we were just live streaming. So I have some thank yous and I have some things to tell you, so bear with me. When I do these, I end up feeling like the jazz club owner that I always hated. Dude, shut up and let us hear the music, right? And now I've become that guy. And so first and foremost, I'd like to thank the Furman Humanities Center for a generous grant that has supported Jordan's visit to us here today. They sponsor a wide array of different activities on campus, and we're really grateful for their support here. As always, I would like to thank the terrific Lex person up in the sound booth, whose job is very easy tonight, is just to make sure that you can hear me speak. And Jordan, we don't have a whole lot of sound to do tonight. We've got some events coming up. Hopefully you found the program on the little credenza out there. We've got still have some other stuff this semester. April 14th, the Furman Jazz Ensemble will perform with the great trombonist Ryan Keverly. He's a young guy who lives in New York. He has just gotten back home from a couple week tour with the Maria Schneider Jazz Orchestra on the West Coast. He frequently is called upon to sub in the Saturday Night Live Orchestra. He's got a couple of his own groups, and they've got a bunch of records out. He's terrific, and he'll be here to play with the band on April 14th. A couple days later, we have our spring combo recital, and then we kind of wind things down for the spring. If you're on Facebook, you can like Furman Jazz Studies and get more information. I recently figured out how to schedule posts, so now I'm posting more because kind of do them rapid fire instead of having to remember to do them. We've got a jazz camp coming up in June with collaboration with the Greenville Jazz Collective. It's June 25 to 29. There will be nightly concerts, except for one important night, which I'll come back to, in this room at 7:30-ish, I think, is when we do them. And those are free. You can come on every night that week and come check it out. If you happen to know youngsters who might be interested in spending all day, every day, for 5 days in a row with us doing jazz, we would love to know about them, and we'd love to have them here this summer. Enrollment is off to a fast start, but it runs through the end of April. We do put caps on certain instruments, and we'll cut certain things off at certain time, because it is kind of a first-come, first-serve sort of thing. While I'm on the topic of the camp, I mentioned that there's one night that's special. After we decided when the camp was going to be, after we decided to publicize the event, after we printed all of our promotional materials and set the cost of camp and mailed all these things out and started with the email and social media campaign about camp, we learned that the great Herbie Hancock was going to be in town on Monday at Jazz Camp. And there's been on a budget for this. Jazz Camp is, you money, and then we pay that money out to the faculty that work for us in the summer, into the dorms, and all these things. There's no budget, there's no funding source other than the money that the students pay to come to camp. Whatever funding I might have access to is designed for our Furman students for experiences like this while they're in Ireland. sorry, the comedy shtick is coming to the fore tonight. We are collaborating, as we always do with camp, with the Greenville Jazz Collective, and we are asking people to consider donating to help us send some of our campers to be able to see Herbie Hancock. Having a jazz camp and having one of the true icons of jazz 15 minutes down the road feels really, really weird, especially if we were here playing a concert for the students when they could go see him. And we don't want to really pass that cost on to the campers after we've already advertised those things. So we have a mechanism to be able to donate if you were to feel comfortable and interested in doing so. I'll be around. I can get your email address and I can send you some information if you'd be interested in checking that out. I don't often, in fact, this is the first time in 21 years that I've asked anybody to donate a dime to Furman for anything that we do. But we want to make sure that we have a camp where either everybody gets to go see Herbie or everybody stays here with us. And we would prefer the former. So you can see me or send me an email. It's matt.olson@furman.edu. All right, you're done hearing from me. You want to hear from this guy. We're really excited to have a really young and amazing saxophonist here with us tonight. He'll be playing with my faculty colleagues, Matt Dingledine on guitar, Shannon Hoover on the bass, and Justin Watt. Jordan VanHemert is the director of jazz studies at Columbus State University in southern Georgia. What town is it in Columbus? What town are you in?
Columbus, yeah.
It is actually in Columbus, okay. I'm from Wisconsin, where I know. He's got some really amazing and interesting albums out. I Am Not a Virus, Nomad, and I think there's some stuff that is recently recorded that is either coming out slowly or coming out soon. He's a Selmer saxophone endorsing artist, a Van Dorn Reeds endorsing artist, and I know you're going to enjoy. I'll let him talk more to you about the music that he's going to play, because it has a really interesting origin, and I want to make sure that you learn a lot about that. But please help me get me to my seat so I can enjoy this and give a really warm, further welcome to Jordan VanHemert.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for coming out. It's truly a pleasure to be here in Greenville, South Carolina. It was an interesting drive today from from Columbus through Atlanta, and I'm seeing nods, and you all know what I'm talking about. So thank you all so much for having me. I'm really, really thrilled to be here, and you all made the drive worth it. It's so great to see so many people here. That was a traditional Korean folk song called Doraji Taryo, and it's a song about the Korean balloon flower. So the lyrics are really joyful. Interestingly enough, it's one of not a ton of super happy Korean folk songs, actually, believe it or not. We'll get into that in a second. But yeah, it's about this Korean balloon flower, and it's indigenous to Korea, and so it's one of our kind of national symbols. The next tune that we're about to play is an arrangement by a wonderful pianist named Lisa Sung, who I met in Michigan when I was living there. And this tune is entitled Half Moon. And this is, I always think about how to explain these types of songs to people, but this is a Korean children's song. So it's kind of folk music that's been written for singing to children. And so this one is really special to Lisa because she sang it to her children all the time. And she's a really, really great pianist. And today we have what I think is a really special treatment of it by this wonderful band that will feature Matt Dingledine on the guitar. And it's really what I loved about it when I heard him playing. He was just frankly just kind of messing around before we started rehearsing it, and it sounded just like the Korean kayagum or the 12-string zither, and I thought that was really cool. And so we've incorporated that, and it's kind of a taste of that sort of tradition. So really, really happy to be here, and I hope you enjoy Half Moon. Thank you. Thank you so much. This band is incredible. I can't believe you get the honor of hearing them all the time. I was in rehearsal with them earlier and I just kept running through tunes, which is not typically something that you want to do during a rehearsal, but it was because I was so distracted by like how amazing that these guys are and just the incredible music that you're making at the drop of a hat. So please give it up for Matt Dingledine on the guitar. Shannon Hoover on the bass. Justin Watt on the drums. I'm having so much fun up here. This next tune is called Imjin River. And, you know, it's a really interesting song because it's about the river that goes across the demilitarized zone in Korea. And so it's a river that's in both North and South Korea. Which is really interesting, kind of an interesting metaphor for the country's reunification. And because of that, it kind of originated in North Korea, or what would have then been North Korea, it was before the separation. And it got banned in current North Korea. And so, especially there was a time that people enjoyed kind of singing it, especially in like the early 1900s or the 20s of this. The 20th century, and so it got banned in North Korea, and then a Japanese group called the Folk Crusaders picked it up, and then it got banned in Japan because it was said to be anti-imperial, and so now we have it here today in the United States where it hasn't gotten banned yet, so that's great. Anyway, this is kind of a fun song that I enjoy playing, and it's full of kind of sadness, because the speaker in the original poem talks about Korea and how they long for this river to not be the only thing that essentially unites the country. And like I said, that is part of the reason that it got banned. And you know, it is it's a beautiful song, but it has this very Korean quality. Called Han, and Han is like, some people explain it as like the Korean version of the blues. It's a little bit more complex than that. It's Korean generational sorrow that's brought on by years of colonialism and being colonized by both Japan and China and all sorts of other things. And it's said, you know, that it flows through our blood as Koreans. So this is a beautiful song, it's got a great melody, but it also has this quality of Han, which is kind of said to be in all of our blood as Koreans. So I hope you enjoy Imjin River. Thank you. Today in the masterclass with the students about how every band that you have can bring something really special to a tune. And if you humble yourself and allow yourself to absorb the, and really, frankly, just trust the musicians around you, it can lead to some really cool things. And so back there just said, yep, just how he wrote it. And the ending there is pretty improvised. And so letting the rhythm, this amazing rhythm section, take that and kind of run with it has been really fun. And in rehearsal, they did something equally cool but completely different. So it's one of the great joys of writing music like this. So the next tune that we're going to play is actually one that nobody really has ever heard before. And I wrote it kind of a while ago, but I haven't had a ton of chances to play it. It's entitled Jack of All Spades. And it's kind of like it's jazz musicians really like puns. Like there's this great tune by the great Lee Konitz that's called Subconsciously, like subconsciously, like the word, anyway. if you explain it, it's not cool, I guess. So I kind of wanted to riff on that a little bit, and this is kind of my tribute to two of my heroes, and I'm writing this. This is for my upcoming record that I'm recording in May, and this was written as a feature for the great Lewis Nash, who will be playing drums on the record. And so this was written kind of with a little bit of the Thad Jones tradition. It's based on a little bit on a tune and on the kind of jocular, funny nature of the tune called Tiptoe, if you've heard the Thad Jones by Lewis Orchestra. And it's also based on these bridges, the B section, to tunes that, like Benny Golson writes. I really love Benny Golson's writing, and what I especially love about Benny's writing is his bridges are really, to me, very attractive. So it's kind of like, I think I described it as like it's Tiptoe, except for the bridge is like a Benny Golson tune or something. And then Matt actually pointed out that it sounds kind of like Parisian Thoroughfare, right? Afternoon in Paris.
Parisian Thoroughfare.
Parisian Caravan. Oh, yeah, that's right. There's a little part in it that sounds like that, so you can listen for that. Nothing new under the sun, right? But this tune is called Jack of All Spades. We certainly hope that you enjoy this performance. It'll feature the wonderful Justin Watt back there on the drums. Shamelessly stole, and it's all good because I wrote a tune, an arrangement for her record, and so we kind of freely share arrangements and steal, but this one is so good I had to steal this also. This is called Lullaby for an Island Baby, and basically it's about a mother who, excuse me, who goes and shucks oysters. And as she is shucking oysters, all she can think about is the baby that she left in a cottage by the sea, and her child. All she can think about is that. So some of y'all who are parents may be able to relate to that. If you're out doing something, you're just thinking about your child. And meanwhile, the child is just alone, and she rushes back. She doesn't even have half a basket full of oysters because she's so worried about her child. She's just consumed by these thoughts of her child. And then she rushes back and she finds the baby fast asleep. And that's the song. This is called Lullaby for an Island Baby. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
you so much. That was a lullaby for an island baby. The next tune that we are going to play is an arrangement of mine, of one of my other favorite artists. This is Stevie Wonder's Superwoman, Where Were You When I Needed You. Yeah, see, that's my reaction too. I love Stevie Wonder. He and I both share a common Michigan heritage. And so this is another tune that I would arrange for my upcoming project. And I wanted to share with you all tonight. It's one of my, probably one of my all-time favorite songs. I just think the way it grows out of the seasons and the metaphor of the seasons as the tune changes keys and goes through all these different modulations is a really beautiful metaphor of the for the passing of a relationship. So please enjoy Superwoman. Thank you. So much to these wonderful musicians. Wow, this is just such an amazing joy to collaborate with them. Give it up for Matt Dingledine on the guitar. And Shannon Hoover on the bass. Justin Watt on the drums. I'd like to give the most effusive thanks to Dr. Matt Olson, the Furman Jazz Studies Program, and of course the Furman Humanities Center for having me this evening. Absolutely thrilled to be here on your beautiful campus. I could not get over how gorgeous this campus is, seriously, like, just incredible. Thank you for having me. It's been a joy to play some music for you this evening. And we're gonna close with one of the great pieces of the standard jazz repertoire. I always love playing standards with people because everybody has a slightly different way of playing them, but it's a common vocabulary that we can all share. This is a great tune called This I Dig of You by the great Hank Moore. Thank you.
Thank you.